Well, my name is Elliott Winton, a professor of hematology and medical oncology here at Winship Cancer Institute, Emory University, and specialize in treating patients with myeloid malignancies. Done this for over 40 years. We're very much focused on myeloproliferative neoplasms. We usually see anywhere from 2 to 3 new cases a week. We have a heavy workload that involves 3 clinics a week, and we do all the work that's involved in conducting the clinical trials.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Great to see you. It's extremely important that we know our patients well. We spend a lot of time on their first visits, trying to get to know them. Quite often they're really bewildered. They don't understand the disease. They find on the internet, they've got all sorts of information. We do our best to educate them about their diseases and getting them to understand what they can expect and how we can manage things. And when appropriate, get them into clinical trials. You basically have cells that circulate around your blood.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing them well translates out into being able to really deliver care that's centered on trying to give them back some good quality in their lives. On times when we're not in the clinic, I'm doing paperwork research, reading and planning for what the next set of studies are going to be and so forth. It is not ever finished. There's a lot of long days and quite often weekends. Well, there comes a time when I can't look at another chart. And the one thing I do that helps is I pick up my banjo and I play it for a little while and I get rejuvenated. Part of my psychotherapy is to get together with a group Wednesday evenings and we make music. We enjoy what we do and it's a good time. I do what I love to do, and if I fit the hero category in somebody's mind, I'm always grateful for appreciation for what I do. The real heroes are the patients. The patients and the caregivers that help them through this. All the folks that take care of all the nitty-gritty of getting these patients the care they need. My hope and dream is that we'll take our technology deeper and deeper into the abnormalities in the genome, understand what's gone wrong at the molecular level to the point where we actually do offer curative outcomes for most of these patients. The most invigorating parts, obviously, are when you've cured somebody. So it's when we actually can take a patient that has a lot of symptoms as severely impacting their quality of life and give them back some really good days.